bit life as an introvert as well, because a lot of us feel like we're trying to fix the wrong shit in ourselves,
yeah.
You know, and we're being counterproductive. And life is short. Like, in your 20s is really where you can do the most changing in yourself and your person. Sure.
Man Bug TV, special guest today, dog Ken Banks.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, we got a special guest, but before we get into that, shout out to Breonna Taylor, RIP to her.
Definitely.
How y'all feel?
Rest in peace to Breonna Taylor and everything.
Like, what y'all thoughts?
It's really just, you know, it's fucked up. Sadly, you know, this is how black community get treated.
Mm-hmm.
No justice, but I'm not even surprised about that, bro.
Dudes, vote. See, that's what the old heads were preaching that day.
Yeah. Don't give me heart
about that.
I'm not voting.
It's really tough, man.
It is because it's hard once you get your own head and you like start understanding everything, like. I don't want to vote for nobody. Everybody.
I don't like none of them.
Exactly. We still got to vote. Exactly. Like, but if we want to vote, we got to have somebody that we like.
Right.
Like,
right. You don't have to vote, though.
Mm-hmm.
What you mean?
You don't got to vote?
No, we don't got to vote, but then they're going to probably put a motherfucking fake voting for to fill in our place.
Right. Yeah, that's what happened.
Simulated vote real quick.
You didn't get my vote. You didn't get me physically voted.
Yes,
so
they did.
At the end of the day, it's still going to be what it is.
It's fucked up, though, honestly. The whole election, last election.
Yeah.
I wasn't even old enough to vote for Obama, but that shit sounds easier than that shit do right now.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But I don't know. I feel like, because I don't really get into politics too much. I just know, like, as a person, you tell a motherfucker about how they seem like they is as a person and shit.
Mm-hmm.
And you're like, I don't know if I don't think Trump is what's best for the country, but I don't know Biden like that.
Exactly.
You know, right?
Exactly.
I know I ain't fucking with Trump, though. You feel me? So it's like, you know, I wish there was somebody else we can vote for.
Thanks.
I never voted, but I might vote this time. I feel like I need to, you know what I mean, with everything going on, but... I don't know. It's
tough.
Get out there and
vote,
y'all.
For real.
Man, stop lying to them. You not even going on the vote, bruh.
Bruh, what are you doing,
bruh? Keep it real. Why you over there lying, bruh? You not even going to vote. You telling the people to go vote. Come on,
man.
I got
to do anything, bruh.
All right, we're going to skip. Anyways, we got Ken Banks on the show. Let them know who Ken Banks is.
Man, Ken Banks is just an individual trying to persevere through everything that's going on in America. I mean, everybody got a hard story. Everybody got a sad tale.
Fact.
I'm just same motherfucker as you. I'm just trying to persevere through that. So,
mm-hmm.
You know, that's what I stand for. Just a motherfucker trying to make it, for real.
Mm-hmm.
That's in short, you know what I mean? The long version, we have to take longer than it needs to, you feel me? But yeah.
So how you feel? How you get to where you is today? Like, to feel like you know what I mean? You just want to you about perseverance and stuff. You know what I mean? Like, what made you that type of person?
Man, just understanding that I don't know shit for real, and you know, it's like you know we.
There's a lot to know, bro.
When you're young, you at some point in your life, I think it happened at like 16. You start feeling like you start seeing like how mm-hmm. where your parents went mm-hmm. wrong, where your auntie, uncle. You start seeing people's flaws.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then you start thinking, like, if I see that, why they don't see that, you know?
Right.
And then you start going with that mindset, then you start bumping your own head. And then you're like, damn, I don't know shit. Like, I'm about to be somebody else gonna look at me in the future like, that nigga don't know shit, you feel me?
What the hell is he doing?
Yeah, you know, and it's like, man, I had to learn the hard way, you know? And sadly, it's more, I hate to say that's like that in the black community, but I think in just, you know, we're poor communities
where
that's the commonality.
Facts.
They try to make it seem like it's black, but it's really just, it ain't. It's always poor versus rich.
Because white people go through the same shit.
Hell yeah.
Facts.
You know?
Definitely.
Shit, more times than not. The motherfuckers be the ones out there panhandling and shit like that, but,
mm-hmm.
you know, not even on a racial thing. It's just more just an economic thing, you know? And that's when I realized, like, it wasn't like these people didn't know, it's that they was never educated about that shit.
Right.
You know? So, shit, trying to educate myself on it.
I feel it. Shoot.
So before this, so you was talking about like stopping smoking.
Yeah.
Talk about that, like.
So with smoking, you know, high school, I'm just keep it a bean. Like, I was listening to Wiz Khalifa in middle school, you know?
Bro, that's how I started smoking. Bro.
For real.
Go ahead, bro.
You listen to that shit now? That nigga is really pushing weed on motherfuckers. Yeah, right. He got that one song. He said, if you don't smoke, I don't know why. Yeah. And then he be like, damn, I don't know why. You know? But I remember, like, you know, I always played football. I, you know, grew up in Alabama. I moved from here when I was 11. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I played football in high school. I remember all my teammates start smoking, popping pills, and all this shit like that. I used to be like, yo, what the fuck?
You know? Didn't want to be like that.
Yeah, you know? But then, like my senior year, I really, like, I started hanging out. You know, senior year, you about to go out. You feel me? Yeah, like, man. Shit, yeah, you feel me? I was talking to scouts and shit like that. I played strong safety. I was talking to scouts. And then I was like, you know, nobody told me about how important the GPA was. You know, I thought, nigga, if I get to the next grade, I'm good. You know? Mm-hmm. I didn't like that. That shit follow you and shit. And mm-hmm. High school ended. I had a 2.4. Dead ass. Like, that shit fucked up. Like, you hear me?
Set up for it.
They didn't even, like, yeah.
I didn't even know it. So what happened was, there was, like, you know, I talked to a lot of different schools. Auburn, South Cal, you know what I mean? Because, like, mm-hmm. I'm 6'3", strong safety, who hit. Mm-hmm. You feel me? So it looked good on paper. Right. But then I was like, yo, coach, this cat, his grades. And then it's like, all right, you got to get a good grade on the ACT. Boy, I ain't studied for that. I'm thinking, like, nigga's gonna show up like any other test. Take that shit. You feel me? This is another thing, just being uneducated. You feel me? Man, and you show up, you're like, boy, this is the hardest shit I've ever did in my life.
You start guessing on anything.
Hey, shit, God. I'm gonna eat breakfast that morning, boy. I'm sitting here, like, in my mind, I was like, yo. In my mind, yo, I'm like, ACT, my high school was hosting the ACT this time. So I'm like, yo, it's about to be, and my city is 7 high schools in the city. So you're like, yo, it's about to be gang of motherfucking bitches here. You feel me? Mm-hmm. And like, I'm like, so that's what me and my homies really went to try to see all the other girls from the different high schools. Mm-hmm. Whole time. That shit was a headache, bro.
Yeah,
so
God.
I did bad on that shit. You get 2 free ACTs. Mm-hmm. And I got an 18 on that. So after that point, they was like, yeah. So it went from like talking to these colleges. No, for real, like, I'm just keeping
it
real.
You got an 18?
I got an 18.
Hey, what's a good score then?
The highest, I think, is like on the ACT, like a 34.
Yeah, I'm about to say, yeah.
Oh, I thought it was like a 25. Like, you got to get
34.
Oh, yeah, 34 ACT. Mm-hmm. I know, like, my people take SAT up north, but it just take the ACT, so I think, like, the highest 34, 35, something like that. So you got to think. I mean, the score I got would have been okay if my GPA was good. If I had a 3.4, right. They'd be like, oh, okay, cool, because we know he can do the, you know, the curriculum.
Right.
It's just like, you know, this bulk test might just be more challenging for him. So, coach, but it's like, you know, they look at that, they like, I don't know if he's going to be able to pass college classes, you know? Mm-hmm. So then after that, I dislocated my shoulder, missed the rest of my senior year. I had an option to go play D3, and I was like, coach, I ain't doing this shit. And then niggas start smoking. That's how I go. Start smoking, and then I just got super addicted to that. And then, turned 19, moved out of the South and shit, thought I was on some better shit, gone for 2 weeks, and me and my homies tried to stage a robbery. Like, you know? So, no, for real. Like, on some, you know, but like, I don't consider myself a street nigga. I ain't on that shit. I don't consider myself a thug, none of that shit. You just young
decisions.
And dumb.
You just made some bad
you know?
Decisions.
It's just due to your environment, you thinking like, you know, cause when you around that shit, you like, oh, this ain't nothing, it's light. You know what I mean? People do this shit all the time.
Right.
And then, but that wasn't meant for me, you know what I'm saying? You know, good Lord willing that it didn't go that set that road for me and shit. Actually, my best friend, his pops is on parole. He just got out. You know what I mean? So the detective called him like, yeah, we about to charge them with, you feel me? And he was like, you know, y'all got to go up here. After he trying to fight us and shit, you're like, y'all got to go up here and tell them you did that shit. You feel me? That it's a theft. It's not no.
Mm-hmm.
So then after that, they gave us 2 years probation on that. I was dropping dirty like a motherfucker because I thought weed was my motherfucking life.
Mm-hmm.
And,
thought they was going to help you. I thought they wasn't going to care about it. Like, shit.
Yeah, and they kept dropping my ass, goddamn. I dropped dirty twice and shit. And then after that, I dropped clean one time, but I took the soda and shit like that. I was stopped smoking, but then my homie was like, yo, fuck this shit, bro. Like, ooh, what, 20 days, you feel me? That shit, he like, I don't think it's got to take a whole, you know, niggas start thinking that. Niggas be addicted. Like, hey, it shouldn't take a whole 30 days to get this out of your system. You should be able to smoke. Like, nah, nigga, that shit take 30 days, bro. On probation and shit, that's when I realized that I could actually stop smoking. And then, I mean, but still after that, like I said, when you're around people all the time, you really be like, damn, I'm smoking, now I'm back at it a couple of days, and, you know. And around that time, I was always trying to, like, this shit funny because it kind of reminded me of, like, fucking, like Jay-Z and shit. Like, you know, sometimes based on your circumstances, you be in the, you live in the hood, that's where you're from, you know. But you're like, damn, I be wanting to, like, do on the business side or on the corporate side. And,
some shit you can't get out of.
Yeah, you can't get out of, you feel me? And like at the time, I was 19. I was like assistant manager. Like these people starting a business and shit. And I got on like right underneath them. You feel me? So I was like, boom, next in line after my employer and shit. Around that time, like you meet my homies hustling and shit. Niggas coming in, gold chains on, smelling like weed and shit. You feel me? And shit like goddamn fucking paid them food. Like I'm ace and shit. You feel me? And it's like my homies, like for real, bumping, pull up Mustang, bumping and shit like that. You know, and it was like, damn, you feel me? Like this my best friend. You feel me? And it was like, you know, I started realizing that like, damn. What we think is normal ain't fucking normal.
At all.
It's not. And we condition to think that that's normal. Just based on our environment. Thanks. And like when you get somewhere else and people look at you crazy, you be like, yeah, they tweaking. You be like, oh shit. They not tweaking. Like, this just like, this ain't normal.
Yeah.
You feel me? And like, it really started making me think a lot, man. As I said, I started getting into reading and shit like that. And I started understanding, like, I started studying successful people and how people make it out of the hood. You know, without music, without sports and shit like that, or how other people like, cause a lot of people, you know, get the, you know, misunderstanding that a lot of white people inherit their money or some shit, but a lot of them of us came from that shit too. You feel me? So I start like studying, like damn, like highly successful people, not like you know regular successful, like highly successful people. How you become a billionaire? What you know? How they do that?
That was some books that you was reading.
This all type of shit, you know. I just start because like you find a lot of that stuff on YouTube too. Like it's this dude on YouTube, Evan Carmichael. He do like these top 10 rules videos, but he does it like Oprah's top 10, Floyd Mayweather's top 10, and he would like basically take their clips and shit when they talking about their journey, their life and stuff like that. He just captures that shit and recreate it and put it in a video, and like I just start indulging in all this because I realized that I can't escape my environment. But I can't control what I goddamn consume.
Right. Yeah, and sure.
I started to change that. So after a while, it just took me a long time. But you really kind of go on like, I don't know if y'all listen to Kendrick Lamar and shit. He got an album called The Pimp a Butterfly. Okay. And he talks about how it's like, I don't know when he dropped his album, like 2015, 2016. But it's just the idea that like, when you down bad and you hurt, people be sweating you and shit. You feel me? But when you glow up, like everybody can't stand the caterpillar, but they love the butterflies.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
That's a real ass thing, bro.
For real. Yeah, and that's what the whole album is about. It's just like, you know, just being from not being shit, and then you glow up, and people are like, oh, I remember you and shit. Yeah,
but they don't
like,
see what you done went through.
Exactly.
They remember when they was doggy.
Yeah, they didn't see that struggle side of that shit.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And people used to, I remember being in the kid, like as a kid, my friend used to make it seem like reading and shit was lame.
Right, definitely.
Right. Laughing, those types of guns. Like,
I remember this girl told me, like she didn't say it to me, but she said it in the class. We was in like middle school and shit. And like, she said if a dude don't sag, she think that's sus. You feel me? But it's like, it let you know it just condition your thinking. Like, sagging so normal to you, for nigga not sagging. You think something wrong with it.
Yeah, that's crazy.
So make you like kind of like question not necessarily like the people's thinking, but what's accepted, you know?
Like what they consume. Like, and that's part of what's going on social media. Exactly, bro.
But I was always kind of like, that's when I really started making sure that I protected like my energy, like what was influencing me. You know what I mean? You really got to step away. Like, even OGs and all, you start being like, damn, you telling me this because this is what you think is normal.
Right, exactly.
You know what I mean? Exactly. But now I got to question you and be like, well, shit, well, I don't think that's right. You feel me? Because I saw this do. A lot of people don't do that. You feel me? So a lot of that, you know, just kind of go back with, like, smoking weed. Smoking weed stems a lot of your thinking. That's why when I was a kid, they would say, you know, weed is a gateway drug. Right. People like, man, hell nah. Even I know a lot of people smoke weed, ain't never. But it's like, what it does though is you start to associate with other people who smoke, and there are other people who smoke don't just smoke weed. Mm-hmm. Or if a motherfucker selling this shit, he might not just be selling no motherfucking weed. So now you start, now you got different connections. Now you know what it's like, you know. And I know because I doubt, but I'm not, like I said, I don't proclaim to be on the street or none of that shit. I just grew up in the hood.
Right.
You know, and
you've
I just.
Seen it.
Yeah, you feel me? And I don't know enough about it to know what it is, you know? So I know that. You feel me, motherfucker? Yeah, oh yeah. Shit, you round somebody, motherfuckers is just doing some shit. Oh damn, how much? What kind of pills is them?
Hell yeah.
What them go for on the streets? Mm-hmm. Like, woo. And now you know what I mean? Yeah, now you moving like, them and yeah, shit. Yeah, or, yeah. You feel me? So it's just so, like
the journey and not smoking and everything. Like when you had the urges to smoke and everything. Like was you just like reading and stuff? Like what all was you doing?
Oh hell no! Nah. I started smoking more mild. God damn. Real. And it's funny because I was smoking cigarettes heavy at a point. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, yo, first of all, I'm spending my money on this, and I feel like it's more addicting than mild, you feel me? So, like, that's the last thing I'm trying to stop right now is smoking. That's why I be smoking these filter tips, because, you know, your plastic tips, boy, be zooted off that motherfucker, you feel me? Yeah, you feel me? So, that is harder, and then I smoke a pack a day, you feel me? Mm-hmm. These little filter tips, they're like $2 a pack, so I'm like, all right, whatever, we're going to, you know, try to slow ourselves off a bit. Mm-hmm. But sometimes the best way to break a habit is to replace it with something. Right. Ideally, replace it with something good, but you can't always do that. Sometimes you gotta be like, all right, well, I'm smoking milds and weed. Let me put this down and let me just smoke these milds. All right, boom, now I got these milds. Now let me try to figure out how to get rid of this shit, you feel me?
Yeah.
And just kind of just go from there. I don't remember exactly what I was doing. I think I was just smoking more mild. I think it really just took a couple of days, man. But I started eating more, too.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like facts. Before, like, I weigh 200 pounds now. And I was smoking all the time. I weigh 167 pounds. It's a whole other world. And, like, I realized that, like, I was consumed by that. And I had to, like, create a world that I wanted for myself.
So what was your next steps? Was going in the right direction?
Shit, just reading and just acknowledging the fact that I ain't know what the fuck I was doing.
Yeah.
You know, as a kid, you think that you know. Because you see other people's mistakes, and you think like, oh, if I don't do that, I'm good.
Mm-hmm.
But the difference is, like, everybody got their own trial.
Mm-hmm.
I might understand your situation, like you and your girl tweaking. I'm like, all you gotta do is this. You feel me? But then you look at me, but you look at me like, nigga, all you gotta do is this. You feel me? And it's like, everybody battle was set up for them, because that's kicking your ass. Because based on who you is as a person, you got different pride, you got different flaws, you got different things that make this complicated for you.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why nobody can fight your battle for you. It's only for you. And that shit is literally for you. So, I realized I had to accept my flaws, not to accept them like, oh, this is how I am, you can't change me, but more of like, oh, this is what I got to work on.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
So, I ain't
mean to cut you off. No, you good.
But speaking of that, I remember I seen one of your videos, you talking about an introvert, and that's like what you're saying, like, you got to work on your flaws, like, you got to isolate yourself.
Right.
So, did you do that? Like,
so what, like, the thing is,
an introvert?
Yeah, see, like, for a long time, I did not even know what this was.
Mm-hmm.
Like, my coach, I remember my high school football coach used to be like, you don't even try to go hang out with your teammates. That's why I started doing that shit. But at the whole, like this world is set up for extroverts. And the difference is, because a lot of people, they think an introvert means you don't like people.
Mm-hmm.
But an introvert is just somebody who, their battery, their personal battery gets charged on being alone. Where extroverts, they like socialize and that fuels them. Like, damn, your energy. But to me, it's like, I'm an introvert, so it's like talking. Like, even like, this is cool because, like, I'm speaking about shit that I like, you know, I'm talking about myself. You know what I mean?
Right, yeah.
But if we were just around just talking, I'd be like, woo, boy, it's time to go.
Yeah.
Like, you feel me? So it'd just be like, but the world is set up, even like the idea of school and seven classes and different motherfuckers in each class. Yeah. God damn. Hey, motherfuckers, I gotta meet today.
Right.
Like, you feel me? And it's like, now people wanna read out loud and, like, you know, that make you uncomfortable if you're an introvert.
Right.
You know what I mean? Yeah. And I didn't know. I wish I knew this earlier in life. Like, even like talking to girls, like, I used to try to wait till I catch her by her locker and
man,
shit.
Man, what? I wait till I lock. Well, I hit it on a foot.
After
school. Find out the name real quick.
But like, you know, and it's fucked up though, because some people, like, they think that you lack confidence because you won't do it in front of everybody. It's like, no, so I just maneuver differently because this is what I find comfortable.
That's
like,
right.
Don't think I'm that confident. You know what I mean? Like, you know. Yeah, and so
I was talking to my girl about that the other day because, like, shit, I don't even be like, I be in the house so much, I don't even get no kick out of kicking it with nobody, for real, I can laugh by myself, bro.
These
cats be on the game with me like, bro, shut up, bro, I just be talking like, just kicking it, like,
no, for real.
Singing songs, laughing, shit, I don't even need nobody to have a good time, bro, for real.
And you need to get out more, you need to da-da-da. I'm like, no, y'all need to stay the fuck in the house more, but it's crazy because, like, I remember being, like, everybody, like, dog, ragged, we went to Miami and shit, and it was, like, the worst time for me, I ain't gonna hold you. Like, I loved it because it was somewhere else, but but it's just like they're like, oh, let's go to the club, let's go to the strip club and shit. I'm like, yo, what the fuck? Y'all trying to do too much, yo. Like, you know, I'm trying to sleep in and shit. I sleep. Motherfuckers going on, I'm like, damn, bro, I got a drink for this shit. You feel me? I've been ready to go 3 hours ago. He's talking about what's next. Well, I gotta go home.
He said what's next.
You feel me?
Three in the morning.
That's about what's next. The fuck? I'm tired of faking the funk. I'm ready to go home. You feel me?
But no, that's my problem. Like, sometimes, like, if I start kicking already, man, I'm out, like, already, I'm probably one of them people, like, what's next? Like, but if I'm at the crib, I'm not even trying to do nothing for real. Yeah. Like, that's where I fuck up at, because, like, I don't be trying to go in the crib, or I don't be trying to stop partying where the party is.
Seems shy and awkward and stuff, you know? Some people are just more so ever where they just... they kind of beat themselves up a lot, where it's like, you know, they seem more depressed or more anxious and stuff like that, you know? But like, nobody's, it's not like this or that. Everybody falls somewhere on the spectrum, you know what I mean? Somebody might be like, nigga, 89% introvert, and he seem weird as fuck. His only bond is with himself, like, you feel me? But, you know, it's cold. But it's a part of understanding yourself and being more self-aware, because that's the only way you're really going to develop as a person, knowing yourself.
Exactly.
Trying to, like, be somebody you're not, you're never going to grow. You know?
And nigga take it. All time to really know yourself.
I mean, I remember you was talking about like how you like rapped a little bit before. Like, what made you like start rapping?
Rapping, I always rapped. I mean, when I was like 8, 9 years old, I did a song, and everybody started playing me because I, you know, it's like, oh, you sound like a girl and shit. You know,
you put that on YouTube.
Nah, this was like when I was like a kid. This was like, you know, I don't even know what happened to the song. One of the homies had, I used to live at OV and shit, and when the homies had like a little studio in his crib, and he was like, oh, my mom gone, you can come rap. And I was like, hell yeah, I'm about to, you know, say some whack ass shit. And then like, the girls liked it, the niggas was trying to play me over it and shit, you know. And then like, after that, I was like, yo, I just always, like, I always liked writing, you know. Like, I even took more challenging English classes to try to become better at writing, you know. Like, even like, I wrote it, like I have a book I wrote. I didn't put it out. I feel like it's a little bit more personal. You know what I mean? So, but just to see if I can do it.
I
did that.
You feel like you can write a book or something?
Yeah, I've always felt like I've, you know, I've always enjoyed writing. Music was just like, you know, what I was around. Like, oh, you can rap, motherfuckers rap, you know? So I used to freestyle and rap and stuff. And then, like I said, you know, Black Hood, that's my cousin. So I grew up around him making beats and stuff like that. So after all, I was like, shit, fuck it. Me and my homie, it was like, we just gonna rap, like, you feel me? And a lot of that shit too, I feel like be the weed too, cause it just kind of just go. You be like, oh yeah, we dope, nigga, we the dopest. And you know, but you really be good. You just like, it's bigger than that. It's a business, you know, and you really gotta understand the business side of it, which I get, but I don't want to compromise myself to be no rapper. It's not very, you know, it's not all the time that J. Cole, a nigga like J. Cole, blow up. In the game, be feeling like you gonna have one conscious motherfucker. And not to say I'm conscious, I mean, I'm just like everybody else, you feel me? You know? I don't think I'm no smarter than anybody else. I think I just pay more attention to other shit.
I'm about to say shit, I'm about to say you just pay more attention,
I feel like everybody got a genius at something, like motherfucker. Stephen A. sit here and talk to you about sports all day and shit, but I ask that nigga about some other shit. He's like, what the fuck are you talking about? Like, what is Stephen A.? I don't know nothing about that shit, boy. And, you know,
everybody got a special talent.
Yeah, you know, I just play my lane, so I sound like I'm smart, bro. Like, nah, nigga, you just know A, B, and C. Bring up D, I don't fucking know. You asked me about the election, I don't know. I just know this nigga racist and this nigga weird. I don't know. Shit, who I'm gonna vote for? Shit, whoever they tell me to vote for. Nah, shit. but for real, you know, rapping, man, I just realized, like, also with understanding of being an introvert, I can perform on stage, but like after that, like interacting with people, it's always been challenging for me. Like create bonds, build relationships, always been challenging for me. That's why even like earlier on, like now I'm in a relationship, you know what I mean? But like early on, even with that, like then, like getting in relationships and stuff like that, you know, a girl tell you she like you, you be like, man, I'm gone.
That's crazy, bro. Oh my God, that's like me, bro.
For real.
That's crazy.
It just become too difficult now. Like I'm used to thinking about how I feel, what I think. Like now I gotta think about you, but shit, I don't know if you're thinking about me like that. You feel me? So a lot of that shit just kind of helped me to realize that, like, that ain't what that's not what was best for me long term. I can do it, Like, yeah, if you know, if I blow my YouTube up, I do that, and now I'm like, oh, y'all making music, y'all want to buy my CD, you know? Mm-hmm. They didn't do that because I got a community, but as far as being a rapper, I'm not willing to do everything I have to do. Mm-hmm. Like, what are you willing to sacrifice to get to where you're trying to go? Yes. And for music, I wasn't really willing to sacrifice my comfort, my, you know, myself to do that. Yeah, you know what I mean?
Because that would take, like, a lot of sacrifice, you know what I mean? You said you don't like meeting people and everything. You have to meet hella people.
Yeah, every day.
Well, you got signed. Oh my god. Yeah.
Then you gotta act like you like motherfuckers and shit. Even people be on the interview. I would have been canceled. 50 Cent got this book called The 50th Law. And the whole law is derived on fear. And he says the person with the most power in the room is the person who has a better grasp on reality. And that power isn't being able to control somebody, but just power over their own life. Mm-hmm. You feel me? It's understanding reality. And that, you know, people like to share lies with each other and then they believe the lie. Mm-hmm. You feel me? Like, oh, they only did that because this, and it's just you just justifying, and this is bullshit. Mm-hmm. You feel me? But when you start keeping it real with yourself and the people around you, you're able to be like, well, nigga, you know that's flawed. You could do it and do what you're gonna do. We ain't gonna judge you. Mm-hmm. But nigga, you know it's flawed, nigga. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You cheat on your girl, you get this other girl pregnant and stuff like that. Don't come to me acting like it's lit. Right. Nigga, you flawed, nigga. Right. But I ain't gonna judge you. You my nigga, I love you. You feel me? But you know that's flawed. Just keep it real with yourself so I can keep it, you know, keep it with each other, you know? And that's the thing, and you know, it's a challenging thing. I mean, that shit like that, you can talk about that shit all day.
All day. Crazy. And then there's only a certain amount of people that want to hear that shit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, you know what I mean?
Some people
are
like,
oh, man. Right.
Bullshit. Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We're trying to hear what niggas trying to say. I mean, no, we just trying to
speak the facts real quick.
Right. You know what I mean?
Yeah. That's how I know, like, it's like, this. Like with the video, I know when people see it, it's gonna be like, what the fuck is they doing with this dude? And blah, blah, blah. It's gonna seem so different.
Uh-huh.
You know, but I understand that, but that's how my life is. You feel me? Mm-hmm. I always had an experience with shit. You feel me? Mm-hmm. So it's like when you hit me up, I'm like, damn, I already know it's about to be on some whole different shit. But some people, it's gonna bring a different, some people gonna watch it because yeah.
They wanna see it. Yeah.
Right. They're gonna be like, damn, what the fuck?
Uh-huh. There's some motherfuckers out there listening to shit like this.
Exactly.
Man. You feel
me? Shout out to Ken Bang. Thanks for letting us come through, man. Yeah, giving us a good word today. Give me your IG and everything.
Everything is the Ken Banks on everything. On YouTube is just Ken Banks. That's on everything. So whatever y'all, I don't even like social media, but I got it because what I'm doing. So IG, YouTube, the best things. Other than that, you know, it's whatever.
Facts. Follow us on IG at Bug TV 100. Shout out to Terry Trev.
Facts. Follow your boy Cousin Beef.
Ah, oh, man.